is the most common ailment of foals, with almost every foal experiencing diarrhea at some point. However, as an owner, it can be very difficult to determine if the diarrhea that your foal is experiencing is life-threatening, if you should consult a veterinarian, and what treatment, if any, should be given. In this three-part series, I will review the common, non-infectious and infectious causes of diarrhea and the recommended steps that should be taken when diarrhea occurs. There are many causes of non-infectious diarrhea in foals, such as foal heat diarrhea, errors in feeding, antibiotic-induced diarrhea, parasites, lactose intolerance, and secondary to gastric ulceration and meconium impaction. Foal heat diarrhea is the most common cause of non-infectious diarrhea in foals. This is the diarrhea that occurs in nearly all foals between 7 and 10 days of age. It's called foal heat diarrhea, or scours, because it coincides with the foal's dam's first heat cycle, or oestrus, following foaling. It was previously thought that hormonal changes in the mare's milk composition was the cause of this diarrhea. However, orphan foals, or foals separated from the dam, also experience diarrhea at this time. As veterinarians, we now believe that the cause of this diarrhea is a change in the normal flora or bacteria that populate the foal's intestine, and this causes a transient change in the digestive process, which results in diarrhea. Other causes of non-infectious diarrhea, such as errors in feeding, usually have a history to implicate them. This, for example, is seen in foals which are bucket-fed, such as orphans. Errors can occur in the concentration of the milk replacer used or the frequency of feeding. Lactase is made by the cells in the tips of the small intestinal mucosal brush border. Primary lactase deficiency is rare in foals, but secondary deficiency due to intestinal damage by infectious agents such as rotavirus or Clostridium difficile is not uncommon. Although lactose intolerance can be confirmed by testing, supplementation is inexpensive, practical and safe, and therefore testing is rarely performed. It is important to remember that foals of this age can also be affected with other more serious forms of diarrhea. Infectious causes of diarrhea usually result in a whole body or systemic response to the infection, and the foals are usually depressed and quiet. In addition to this change in attitude, there are several other ways to tell the difference. Monitor the foal's rectal temperature. A foal's normal rectal temperature is between 99 and 101.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Monitor the foal to ensure that he or she is nursing adequately. A normal healthy foal will nurse several times an hour and will run to nurse the mare on someone entering the stall. If the mare's udder is full, dripping milk, or if the foal has milk staining of the forehead, it is likely that it is not nursing adequately and that it is sick. Monitor the foal for diarrhea. Normal nursing foals have a yellowish, pasty manure, which is totally normal. Foals with diarrhea have a more watery feces, which is variable in colour, and diarrhea may stain the hindquarters or can be seen dripping from the tail. If you notice any of these signs in your foal, you should contact your veterinarian immediately and separate the mare and foal from other young stock until the likely cause of the diarrhea can be determined. Thank you for watching. In the second video of this series, I discuss the various infectious agents that often lead to diarrhea in foals.